Hello everyone. Today we will discuss how to stop a disabled user in the Firebase user table from login in Android. This is an application that I have developed and installed, Pothole Fixer. This application is using OTP code for user authentication. So let's open the application. This is the splash screen. Now it's asking for a mobile number to get registered. So putting here a mobile number, this is a testing number that I have already added in the Firebase user table and have assigned a 6-digit code 123456 to this number. Let me show how a testing number is added in the Firebase console. So going to the Firebase console, since my application is using phone number for authentications, so going to this menu. Here you can see phone numbers for testing. Click here, and here you can see that I have added this number and have assigned a 6-digit code to the number. You can add here any number and can assign a 6-digit code in this field. So this is how a testing number is added in the Firebase console. Now coming back towards the application and clicking Get OTP button, wait for some time so that the device get registered, so that the device get authenticated. Now putting OTP code, which is 123456, and click verify button. Now the user has been verified. Let us complete the profile, adding some values, adding a dummy email address and address. Click register button. So the user has been registered and authenticated. What does this authentication means? This authentication actually means that an instance has been created in the mobile memory for this application. Now whenever you will open this application again, it will check for that instance. If the instance is there, it will take you directly to the home page, and if the instance is not there, it will ask for authentications. So let's close the application and open it again to see the behavior of the application. So I'm closing it here and opening it again. So you can see it didn't ask for authentication because the instance is already there in the mobile memory. So how to destroy or clear this instance? Long press application icon, go to app info, clear data, clear all data. So when I will clear the application data, it will also clear instance for this application. Now when I will open the application, it will check for the instance which has been cleared. So it will ask again for the authentication. So here you can see it is asking again for the authentication. So putting here mobile number again, wait for some time. Now put OTP code here and verify. Complete the profile. So the instance for the user has been created again. Now, what will happen if I disable the user on the server side? So going to my console, Firebase console, going to user table, and going to the specific user. This is the user that I will disable. Click here, disable account and disable the user. Here you can see the user has been disabled, and you can see the disabled text below the mobile number here. Now when I open the application again, it should not log in because it has been disabled on the server side. So let's check the behavior of the application. You can see that it didn't ask for authentication and directly took me to the home screen, although this user has been disabled on the server side. It is because this application is checking for the local instance for this application, which is there in the mobile memory and is not checking on the server side. So this is the problem. Now let's check its implementation in the code. So going to Android Studio. In the code here, I am getting local instance of the user and checking its value. If its value is not null, then go to home activity. And if its value is null, then go to mobile number authentication activity. Now, if I disable a user on server side, it will still return a non-null value for user, because here I am getting local instance of the user. In this case, the user will still able to log into the application. To resolve this problem, here I am adding one more check. If user not equal to null, then call reload function. Here I am checking if local instance of the user is existing, then also check user status on server side. So this line of code will check user status on server and will assign value to user accordingly. So if a user is disabled on server side, it will assign a null value to user, which will stop it from login. So now let's run the application and check the behavior. So let's run the application. So the application has been run. Now let's check its status. New APK has been installed. Now let's open the application and complete the registration process. So the user has been registered successfully. Going to Firebase console to disable the user. Click here, disable account, and click disable button. So the user has been disabled. Going back to application. Now there are two use cases. First, turn off mobile data to get the device disconnected from internet and open the application. Here you can see it didn't ask for authentication. Although the user status is disabled on server, it is because the device have no internet access and didn't check user status on server. It checked only local instance for the application. Now turn on the mobile data and check the behavior. Open the application. Close it again and open it. Now this time it is asking for authentication. It is because the device have internet access and it checked user status on server, which is disabled. So it stopped the application from login. And that is the basic functionality of reload function. So in this tutorial, we learned how to stop a disabled user in the Firebase console from login in Android. Or in other words, what is the exact functionality of reload function in Android. So that's it for this tutorial. Thank you.